and welcome to the Double T Insider. I'm Caitlin Kravick alongside Brett Brown, bringing you the inside access into Texas Tech athletics.
In this week's episode, we speak with Red Raider basketball's competitive guard, Randy Onwuasor.
From walk-on to scholarship, we speak with Red Raider football's junior deep snapper, David Brenner.
These guys know about Texas Tech tradition better than anyone else. This week, we sit down with the Texas Tech Saddle Tramps.
We also feature Red Raider football senior kicker, Ryan Bustin. Coming up after the break, we visit with Texas Tech football's defensive coordinator, Mike Smith.
Double T Insider is brought to you in part by Plains Capital Bank, a proud supporter of Texas Tech football. Ride with the good guys at Plains Capital Bank, Texas Farm Bureau Insurance. Visit RedRaidersContest.game to register to win cool fan experiences. And by Texas Ford Dealers. Visit your Texas Ford dealer today. Ford is the best in Texas.
Welcome back to the Double T Insider. I'm Alexandra Haley. This week we feature our head defensive coordinator, Coach Mike Smith.
Being from Lubbock, I've always been a big Red Raider fan, just their tradition. And you know, my father and my mother were huge Tech fans, and we went to every game. You know, I grew up loving Zach Thomas and Marcus Coleman and Bam Morris. So it was a no-brainer when I was getting recruited out of high school by other colleges. I always wanted to go to Tech. That's why I'm back here. You know, I've turned down NFL jobs since I've been back, and people think I'm half crazy because of it, but I love Texas Tech. And there's no place I'd rather be. Yeah, it's a rare deal just because I'm so close with Cliff and Kevin and Trey and Eric and all those guys. You know, what's good about these guys, we're all competitive. We're almost all kind of the same athlete. We all have a lot of offers coming out of college. You know, we were all successful by being overachievers, by working hard and staying after and doing the little things. And that's how we are as coaches. I mean, every one of us get here around 4:30, 5 o'clock in the morning every morning. And that's when you know you're going to be successful, when it means something that much to you. And as coaches and what we do, it's pretty special. Just good character kids. You know, I was actually talking to Coach King today, and then kids that just love football. That's what I want. You know, you can like basketball, you can like baseball and play, but you got to love football to play this game, and that's what I want. I want kids that love going out there in 10-degree weather and playing football and excited to be out there. And that's, you know, that's me, and that's a lot of our coaches. You know, I just have so much passion for this game, and I want to find kids that have the same passion. So that's what I'm looking for, guys off the field to do the right thing and guys that truly love what they do, play football. My leadership style, I think it's just, like I said, what I look for, I think that's just me, how I am and how I coach. I just love this game. And what's great too is I love this university. And so I think those guys feed off of that. You know, somewhat my success of playing in the NFL and coaching the NFL, and I just share that with them, how I made it. I wasn't very athletic, very fast, very strong, but I made it being tough and smart and physical and playing violent and playing with emotion. I think what's impressive is really a lot of the guys, just the fact, like you said, we have been beat up, and a lot of guys that you know, haven't got a lot of reps stepped in, and they keep fighting. You know, that nobody's really taking a knee and giving up. Sam McGuavin, you know, he's been injured, but I think he's been our biggest leader on defense. Pete, you know, Pete Robinson, Pistol Pete, is having a great year. He's leading the Big 12 in sacks, but he's a guy that I talked about that loves football. He loves football. And you can tell the way he practices, the way he prepares, everything. He's a true warrior. I tell him all the time, you're a true warrior. You know, there's a lot of guys that stepped up. Keenan Ward is having a great year. J.J. Gaines, those guys. But, you know, as long as they keep fighting and having fun, we'll be fine. Yeah, I got, back in my call sheet, I got my wife and my son. It just, that's my world, my life. That's the reason I wake up at 5 a.m. I do everything for them, and I love them. That's everything I do is for them. So, you know, every once in a while, I'll take a between series, I'll look at it, and I do everything for them.
Coming up next, we spotlight Red Raider basketball's Randy Onwuasor.
My name is Randy Onwuasor. I'm from Inglewood, California. The transition is real different. I mean, you're playing with grown men now. You're not playing with 16-year-olds, 15-year-olds. You're playing with grown men out there. So it's a different, I mean, it's different. Me coming from California all the way here to Texas, about 1,000 miles away, it's different. You know, you have to adapt to weather, time changes and everything. The West Texas culture is different for me because I'm coming from a city. I'm not used to seeing cotton, fields and everything like that. I'm used to seeing buildings and everything like that. So it's different for me, but I'm adapting to it well. Where I come from, not that many people make it out. People are usually doing drugs, game banging, doing other things in life. And it's just a blessing for me to still be here just playing basketball. Some of the personal things I worked on was my ball handling. I worked on my shooting. I really focused on my shooting a lot because my shooting percentages was down last year, me being a freshman. And I just worked on just being confident in my game. That fan base helps. It's great because it gives us that edge and that enthusiasm coming into the game. When we go out there, we see 15,000. And you in warm-ups, you're like, man, it's a lot of people out here. We can't lose. A lot of fans, it helps. I mean, it helps us get that enthusiasm, that edge, and that desire to win, be the best. He pushes us, he gets us better. His coaching style is mainly on defense. If we're not playing defense, he's really mad. I mean, he really doesn't too much so care about offense. He wants us to play defense. Defense is the priority on this team. He added tons of good players. We have Justin Gray, a real athletic wing. We have tons of athletes now. Like, our whole team is just athletes. Run, every dunk, everything. We're pretty good now. Our biggest strengths would be just us running, because we're so athletic. I think we can get out and push the tempo and make people tired and just keep the tempo up. The team bond has been pretty good. I mean, we still not there yet, but we still have a long way to go. But we've been gelling and getting it together. Sometimes I talk to Keenan, I tell him where to be on the court. Since I've been here last year, sometimes I just talk to the freshmen and tell them, oh, this is where you need to be, this is what you need to be doing at this time. I just talk to them, give them some advice that'll help them. The key leaders would probably be Gocher and Rob. Those would probably be our key leaders. They played a lot of the minutes last year. They know what it takes to get it done, and those are both our starter guards. So I think those would be our key leaders on the team this year. And myself, and Ross, and Clark and Luke will just have to fill in and just be behind them and supporting them.
Coming up after the break, we're featuring Texas Tech football's deep snapper, David Brenner. Welcome back to the show. This week, we sit down with Texas Tech football's David Brenner.
My name is David Brenner. I'm from Plano, Texas. I'm a redshirt junior, and I'm the deep snapper. Really, I didn't really get started till junior high. I went to a small private school in Richardson, Canyon Creek, and my dad played in college, and back at my old school in Fort Worth, we didn't have a football team, and so when we moved to Plano, I went to the school in Richardson. They had a football team, and I tried out in junior high, and that's how I got started. Always a dream to follow my dad playing football. It was pretty crazy. I mean, I went on my visit here just a couple weeks before my own graduation high school, and I had some other opportunities at different schools and took a visit here and got a preferred walk-on. So I knew that I was going to be ahead of just normal, just try and walk-ons, you know, during the season. So I had my foot in the door already. And I got invited a week into fall camp just because some injuries happening here. And just got my foot in the door and just kept working. And so that's how I kind of whole walk-on situation here. It's pretty surreal, the scholarship, just because it just takes the load off my family's shoulders and everything just financial wise. You know, I worked my butt off to come get here, and it's kind of pretty cool to work with you know, the rest of the guys that came in as walk-ons, you know, with a lot of my buddies, you know, walking in the same day and knowing that we had a ability to be on this team and as a walk-on and try to earn a scholarship. And it was pretty cool how me and a couple of my buddies got the same day and everything. We all kind of reunited and share some laughs and good memories from being a walk-on and just getting that scholarship. You know, all the coaches here, Tech grads and everything, and so I think just the team bonding and the coaches really, you know, talk about life outside of football. You know, a lot of the coaches have brought in former players that, you know, haven't gone to the next level, but right now they're living in the real world, and so they kind of give us the full approach of how it's life is without football and kind of gets us ready, you know, to go out in the real world and work a real job. And so really just don't regret anything you have here. And that's why, you know, every day we come ready to work and just keep working every day. Leadership and qualities, I mean, me being a specialist, it's kind of hard to kind of have that voice on the team just because just the way my role is. I mean, I'm not the star, I'm not the player on the field. But for me, just doing my job and just keeping my head down and working every day and really just not mess up on the field. I mean, really as a specialist, you have one opportunity, and if you mess up, obviously everyone's gonna notice, you know, when you do. But for me, just being in the weight room and just working hard and staying out of trouble and just lead by example. I mean, just not making many mistakes on the field and just do my job. I think for me, I don't really have a vocal leadership role, but I think just me doing what I do every day, I think that's my leadership role on this team. Me being a senior next year, I think I may have a vocal leadership just on the special teams unit overall and leading this special teams unit to higher standards.
Stay tuned. After the break, we're featuring the Texas Tech Saddle Tramps. This week, we sit down with the boys who keep Texas Tech's spirit alive, the Saddle Tramps.
My name is Ty Vaughn. I'm a senior from Frisco, Texas, and I am the current president of the Saddle Tramps. Well, we're actually the oldest student organization on campus. This is going to be our 78th year here at Texas Tech, so founded in 1936 by a man named Arch Lamb, who is a cheerleader at Texas Tech. He founded the organization due to the fact that there was a little bit of a misdirection as far as the energy was going from the student fan base. It was very rowdy, very uncontrolled, and so Arch Lamb was elected the first president of a group of individuals, of a spirit group of all males who would be dedicated to the betterment of Texas Tech. And who would basically try to channel that negative energy into something positive. And while we've expanded a lot in our responsibilities and the things we've taken part of, we still wear the same uniforms that we did back in the 30s, and it's very much an organization centered on tradition. We go to every single football game on campus, all the basketball games, and all the baseball games as well, and we take part in really anything that betters Texas Tech. We're the organization that the university calls.
I'm Parker Sundling. I'm from Carrollton, Texas. I'm 19 years old, and I'm the secretary in Saddle Tramps. I first got involved in Saddle Tramps by actually getting a letter in the mail before I was a freshman during that summer. I saw it and I was like, okay, it's cool, I guess. I guess I'll check it out. I went to the open rush night and I ended up looking in this room full of a diverse set of guys that just loved Texas Tech. And that's when I knew, like, I loved Saddle Tramps so much. And that was the place I needed to be. I just saw all the passion and drive that these guys had, and I felt like I could fit in pretty well.
Jason Barrett Judd. Senior from Fort Worth, Texas.
I'm actually the former president of Saddle Tramps, and right now I sit on the Student Government Association's Sportsmanship and Traditions Committee for the Saddle Tramps.
I got involved with Saddle Tramps my freshman year of college. I just recently got to Texas Tech and I lived at Gordon Hall. It's one of the historic dorms on campus, and I was really interested in the tradition and service aspects of Saddle Tramps, and that's what made me want to join. Well, our game day prep always begins on Thursday afternoon when we start wrapping the statue. That's one of people's favorite things to see on Friday and Saturday prior to the game. We also get our tailgating ready. We tailgate on Thursday nights, and we have a ceremony called Midnight Raiders where we do a lot of chants and stuff like a pep rally. And we tie streamers to cars as they come on in through the Memorial Circle entrance on campus. And so those are some of the pregame traditions that we do for Texas Tech. So
one of my favorite traditions is actually coming up here next month, the Carol of Lights. When all of campus gets lit up, you have the choir. We obviously play a very big role in lighting the torches and walking around and parading through Memorial Circle and doing all of that. That's one of my favorite traditions.
Another one that I really think is cool is, like, we ring the bells at 30 minutes after every single victory we have here at home. And that's really cool just because anywhere on campus that you are, you will know if we won a game just by hearing those bells.
I would definitely say that you always need to strive for honor and be spirited whatever you do. If you take something that you want to accomplish and put all of your effort and energy into it, more than likely you're going to achieve it.
This week we sit down with the senior kicker for Texas Tech, Ryan Bustin.
Ryan Bustin will come on for the point after.
My name is Ryan Bustin. I'm from Kilgore, Texas. I'm a redshirt senior and I'm a kicker. So basically since I could walk, I mean, soccer's been my passion. I played soccer my whole life. I played select in seventh grade, and then that's whenever I started playing football. And then I knew the team needed a kicker, and I was like, hey, that's for me. And so I did that, and then I did it in eighth grade as well, and I got pretty good at it. And then after that, I knew I needed to make something out of this, and then from then on, that's where I am here today. Probably after eighth grade, I mean, the varsity coaches recognized that I had a really good leg, and so from then on, I started going to all these camps and everything, and then that's whenever I really started dialing it in, and just I started to make something out of it. You know, I came in as a walk-on. I knew that I would have to just prove myself of what I can do, and just kind of played like I had a chip on my shoulder, like everyone was against me, and just I just had that mindset and then just got to where I am today. Just kept working. I have a good bond with the short time they've been here. I have a really good relationship with Coach Cheverini. He's been a great guy and great influence on me. Coach Kingsbury and the rest of the staff, I mean, I've seen a lot of coaches come in and out through this program. They bring a lot of energy to practice, something not so much maybe the last coaching staff did, but them being so young, they bring a lot of energy every day to practice, and that really rubs off on the players. Not so much a vocal role, just because, I mean, I'm a specialist, I'm a kicker. Just from my point of view, like, I have to remain calm throughout a game and everything. So just doing my job and then just supporting my teammates whenever they make good plays. And then I know they have my back, so that's pretty much what role I have. It's been a good experience. A lot of ups, a lot of downs, but I wouldn't change any of it. It's been a good ride.
Coming up after the break, we take a look at the best tweets about Texas Tech athletics. Welcome back to the Double T Insider. I'm Luke Heath. Each week, we pick the best tweets about Texas Tech athletics and air them right here on the show. Keel Unruh tweeted about Lady Raider basketball saying, "Got the win, next stop the Bahamas. Hashtag guns up, hashtag wreck'em, and hashtag fearless family." Tech quarterback Patrick Mahomes tweeted, "Shout out to my boy D. Washington. First 1,000-yard rusher at Tech since 1998. Hashtag guns up." Rick Gilbert tweeted about TTU volleyball saying, "Congrats to TTU volleyball and Breanne David on getting her 1,000 career kill against the Sooners. Hashtag guns up." Tech football special teams coach Darren Shiverini tweeted, "Great win on the road against Iowa State, 34-31. Hashtag guns up, hashtag Texas Tech, and hashtag wreck 'em." Caleb Coy tweeted about soccer saying, "What a run. Made history this year and will do it again in 2015. Hashtag Texas Tech, hashtag TTU soccer, hashtag wreck 'em, and hashtag guns up." Well, that's all the tweets for this week's episode, but be sure to follow the Double T Insider on Twitter and check back next week when your tweet could just be featured on the show. Now let's take a look at Texas Tech's upcoming games.
Lady Raider basketball will compete in the Junkanoo Jam in the Bahamas Friday. Tip-off against Purdue will begin at 2:15 p.m. Central. Texas Tech football will be in Arlington, Texas as they conclude their regular season against Baylor. This series between the Red Raiders and Bears dates back to 1929. Kickoff will begin at 2:30 p.m. Central. Sunday, Red Raider basketball continues their A-game homestand as they face Air Force. Tip-off from the United Supermarkets Arena in Lubbock, Texas will begin at 1 p.m. Central. Lady Raider basketball returns home Wednesday as they begin a 7-game homestand against Abilene Christian. Tip-off from the USA is scheduled to begin at 11 a.m. Central. Texas Tech basketball will face the Auburn Tigers from the USA Wednesday. Tip-off will begin at 8 p.m. Central.
The Double T Insider will return right here after the break.
Double T Insider was brought to you in part by UMC Health System. It's our hospital. Texas Farm Bureau Insurance. Visit RedRaidersContest.game to register to win cool fan experiences. Red Raider Club. Your support, their effort, our fearless champions. And by Texas Ford Dealers. Visit your Texas Ford dealer today. Ford is the best in Texas.
Well, that's a wrap for this week's episode of the Double T Insider. Thanks so much for watching.
Make sure to like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter to stay up to date with Texas Tech athletics. For Caitlin Kravick, I'm Brett Brown, and until next time, guns up.